Hello, let me tell you about a story about a detective called Mason. He had a brilliant idea for investigating crime scenes. The idea wasn't his, of course. It had been used for years and years, and could have been forgotten about, but different investigators still use it when investigating crime scenes. The idea is creating a miniature model of the whole crime scene. For instance, if it was a farmhouse with two people and one stabbed with a knife, then create a model of that entire scene. Mason used to find it very helpful to be able to look at the model of the crime scene and go through it in his mind what could have happened. This method helped Mason solve lots of different crimes. Mason's wife Susan was a teacher in the local school and used to often worry about Mason out and about in his job, but she used to like when he was in the basement with his crime scene miniatures because she knew he was safe at home and wasn't in the way of any criminal that could harm him or worse, kill him. One day there was a murder in the school and Mason had to do a miniature of the hallway by the lockers where the murder took place. He knew that there was just lockers, a school bag and a boy that seemed to have been hit by a hammer. Mason was working hard trying to figure out what he could see in it. Sometimes he wondered, was it harder there being a lot to the scene or less? But he knew one thing, that no matter how much there was in the scene or how little, it seemed to help him having a miniature model. That night Mason seemed to have had a nightmare and woke up feeling agitated after it. He got up to get a glass of water. On his way, by accident, he knocked against his wife's handbag and it fell to the floor, with some of its contents spilt out on the floor. He froze in fear when he saw what he saw staring up at him from the floor. It was a hammer with what looked like blood on the top. He looked back at the bed, hoping Susan wouldn't wake up. He put it together. Susan had been talking about a boy who was constantly bullying her behind people's backs, and she was afraid to tell anyone because she felt they would think she had no control over her students. Mason knew the student was hit with a blunt object, which was very highly likely to be the hammer. Mason felt movement from the bed and quickly put the hammer back into Susan's bag. He went down to the kitchen and drank some water and then walked back to the basement and looked at the miniature model. He imagined Susan striking the student on the head with a hammer and knew that he heard the CCTV footage was missing and that would be explained by Susan being able to have access to it to delete it. Every piece of the puzzle was falling into place. Suddenly he heard movement behind him and looked around. His wife Susan was standing next to him with a miniature model of himself lying in a pool of blood. She put the miniature model of him down on the ground and said, "Well, Mason, I was really hoping it wouldn't come to this, where I have to finish this miniature crime scene, but it looks like I'll have to make the background. Or basement." She pulled out a gun and shot Mason in his head. 6 months later, Susan was speaking at the book launch of her bestseller called My Husband Is Gone, But I Continued His Passion. She spoke into the mic with emotion. "I am here today talking about my book, which is a way of me coping with the murder of my hard-working husband, who was passionate about figuring out ways of solving crimes by using miniature crime scene models. The title is long, but I couldn't think of any other appropriate title to use other than My Husband Is Gone, But I Continued His Passion. My husband was such a loving man, and the only time I was truly content with him working on his investigations was when he was in the basement working on his miniature crime scene models. After my husband died, I tried to harness my emotions into making a miniature crime scene of him in honor of him. I would love if my husband was still alive and I didn't have to write this book, but I want to speak out to the many wives of men like my husband. Don't take a day for granted, because if your husband is working in a dangerous line of work like mine was, then his life could be snuffed out at any minute. The crowd were lapping up Susan's speech, and Susan was enjoying knowing she would get lots of royalties from her books and TV appearances, etc., and her bully was out of the way. She paused for a moment, thinking to herself, "I didn't want to appear a pushover teacher by saying I couldn't control my student, and I didn't want to harm my loving husband, but I had to. I wasn't a murderer, so it's better I got a book deal and wasn't cut out as the murderer. They would think I was some sort of psycho." She saw a fly land in her hand and thought to herself, "After all, I wouldn't hurt a fly."